They elect to shoot first, do the New York Islanders, and they elect to send Jordan Eberle out onto the ice. He's 0 for 2 this season. He was unavailable in the last shootout, the last game here at the Coliseum against the Penguins. Eberle in on Bernier. And Bernier got the right pad out on the backhand try from Eberle.
One of the things that Barry also said is that they always do what we tell them to do. I don't know if that was what they think is a weakness. And there's Franz Nielsen. And Thomas Greiss, very familiar with Franz. So this is an interesting match between these two guys who know each other very, very well.
49 shootout goals, the most in NHL history for Franz Nielsen. And he goes to the backhand and Greiss says no. 50's not coming tonight for Franz Nielsen.
He went with his basic move and didn't get it all the way up. Gets it about halfway, and when Franz is really accurate, he gets it up in the toy department, and Thomas Greiss knew that was coming the minute he kind of came from his left side.
Barzal 1 for 6 in his career, 0 for 3 this season. Coming in with speed this time. He goes to the backhand, cuts back, and places it into the empty net around Bernier. Oh, what a goal for Matt Barzal.
A little different tactic for Matt Barzal as he came in a little quicker. Talked to him the other day about it, Brendan, just about, you know, use your natural gifts and reaction, and you're going so slow, it's tough to do anything. Definitely went a lot faster in that shootout.
Thomas Vanek handed all three Red Wings goals tonight. 2 assists and the game-tying goal late in the third. Fakes the shot, and then he pulled the trigger, and Greiss kicked it away.
Great read by Thomas Greiss. Look at his position. Thomas Vanek comes in fairly quickly, and Thomas Greiss is up above the crease, so that not much to shoot at, makes a nice save. So good aggressive save by Thomas Greiss, not staying back. He knows that Vanek's a shooter. Josh Bailey can bring home the bacon.
First opportunity to win it is Josh Bailey. In on Bernier, and he closed the door as he looked 5-hole.
Gave him a little bit of fake, but Bernier was quick to shut it all down.
So now the chance to win it is for Thomas Greiss.
Going to do it on his own. Little fake there by Josh Bailey, but Bernier was waiting for it. Don't forget the Red Wings steady tape also on the Islander shooters.
Nyquist 1 for 4 this season. Gustav Nyquist on the forehand. Slows, waits, Greiss, delays. He makes the save, and the Islanders win!
Poke check, Brendan. He got a poke check on Nyquist and blew the whistle right away. But what a move by... what a win by the Islanders. I mean, a deserved win. I mean, the Red Wings have got to be thrilled to death they were able to pull a point out of this game, get on the road and get completely outplayed. And for the Islanders, some of the frustration is gone. They scored a power play goal, and they find a way to win a hockey game. Thomas Greiss comes back, makes some big saves in the shootout, likes that poke check. Watch him shoot the stick out, gets it out in front of him, and that's it. Once you make the initial save, it's all over but the shouting, and the Islanders have a big win at home.
Thomas Greiss makes the final save on the 15th win of the season for the New York Islanders. 2 out of their 3 games at the Coliseum have ended with the crowd headed home happy.